And your work package 6.
That's right.
So my name is Ferry Koster, and I'm presenting the work of Work Package 6 here about labor relations and modes of employment. We're doing this package together with SEPS, MSES, UWS, and ESRI. What's going on? So there was something wrong with the... Something was not valid, at least. Okay. So just to give you an idea of what we're going to do in this work package, we defined six different tasks, and the first task is about the political economy of employment relations and labor market models. And the main focus is here to generate, just as in the other work packages that we've already seen, that people are trying to construct or to update existing data sets. This is something that we're also going to do. Then the second part, or the second task, is going to be an overview of the labor relations in Central Eastern European countries. And here we're going to do a quantitative country comparison, at least it's been done by a part of this work package. In the third task, we have labor relations in the economic models of EU countries. This is going to be both qualitative and quantitative, I believe, but the main focus will be on qualitative data, so it's going to be case studies of different countries within the European Union. Then the fourth task is going to be about product and labor market regulations, and it's going to be focused on the effects on innovation and adoption of new technologies, and this is going to be a quantitative impact study. Then we're also going to focus on, what's coming out of these different labor market models. So what are the effects? Oh, what are the consequences of labor market models? People are starting to tear down the walls already. And what we're going to do is to see what's going on, of course, these models are functioning at the macro level, but we're interested in what's going on, or how they affect macro outcomes, but also meso and micro level outcomes. And then finally, we're going to get this together into one coherent, hopefully, policy brief. Just to give you a bit of an idea of what we're planning to do, what are the basic ideas of what we're working on, is that we try to get from, let's say, conceptual normative models about labor relations to measurable variables and to see what's really going on within Europe by developing indicators and by updating existing data sets and by combining qualitative and quantitative data. We try to assess the impacts or the consequences of these models, and we also try to focus on, let's say, the unintended consequences. Of course, there are a lot of intended consequences, but there also may also be both positive and negative unintended consequences. So we try to have a broad methodological focus by combining different empirical strategies, and we also have a different focus or at least a variety of focuses within this team, because we have political scientists, economists, and even one sociologist. So that should give some discussion, I would say, within this work packets. And what we also try to do is to map differences between countries and to see how differences within countries matter within the European Union. For the moment, I will skip this because I think I only have 5 minutes left or so.
Six.
Oh, six. Okay, then I'm not going back. Just to give you a bit more detail about these different tasks. So the first task was the political economy of employment relations and labor market models. Like I said, what we're trying to do here is to map these different models combining all data sets and by updating these data sets and by constructing new and old indicators. So for a large part, this is going to be quite descriptive, I would say, but it also may involve a test of how these models are not scattered, but at least how they differ across these different countries and how they have developed across time. And so the idea is to give policymakers also a bit more insight in what's happening within the European Union and how these models differ between countries. Then tasks two and three are really closely connected. So we put them together here. So to get an overview of, on the one hand, what's going on within the Central Eastern European countries and how labor relations in the economic models in the within the EU have developed. So here we're going to look at the specific characteristics of these models within the European Union and how they have developed. And of course, we acknowledge that a large part of what's going on cannot be captured in these, let's say, very broad quantitative indicators. So what we're going to do is we're going to add qualitative case studies to get more insight about how these models function and how they differ. For instance, by interviewing a representative of unions, employers, and also government representatives, and again to give more insights into how this functions within the European Union. Then the fourth task is about how labor market regulations may influence the adoption and of new technologies and innovation within European countries. Here the idea is to measure and to analyze the impact of product and labor market reforms and innovations by using econometric analysis based on the Schumpeter model of endogenous growth. So this model will be used to conduct these analyses based on existing data sets, but as some of these data sets may be updated within some of the other work packages, it may be interesting to have some cross connections here, I would say, for instance, with your work, of course, and with the idea to give policymakers an idea of what kind of models are working and what kinds of models are not working. And this is also part of the fifth task that not only focuses on innovation, but also on the impact that these different models may have on, the macro economic features, but also on how organizations function, but also how households and individuals function or how they perform or the decisions that they may make. And on the one hand, this may generate information about the intended consequences like, labor participation, which is of course an explicit goal of these social models, or the labor market models. And perhaps it may also give more insights in how the work-life balance may be improved by certain kinds of models. But it may also have additional or unintended consequences. Maybe that certain kinds of innovation may be supported by certain kinds of models, but it may also be hindered by it. And it may also be that, for instance, other life spheres like voluntary work may be disrupted by certain kinds of labor market models because there's so much emphasis on working and labor participation, and that it drives out something like voluntary work. So just to give you a quick overview of R&D, of course, we are cooperators, or actually we're super cooperators, of course. That's something that I just learned the other day. So here's the idea of how we view the world. So we would like to get a lot of input, of course, when it comes to generating these indicators. On the other hand, when we have these indicators, we can provide input to other work packages, and it also relates to the outcomes and the case studies that we're performing. So that's about it.
Excellent.
Thank you.
Excellent. Any questions, anyone?